Her life in dance was both destructive and terribly lucky.
She was the Paganini of all the ballerinas.
This was a great ballerina, an icon.
She was the most gorgeous, luscious,
glamorous.
And she could look like Garbo, she could look like Dietrich.
She was the Dietrich of ballet.
Her spirit was free and she was courageous and innovative.
We don't have many of that kind in our métier.
When it came to dancing, it was purity, it was perfection.
She was a beautiful dancer.
She had extraordinary balance.
I will never forget, as long as I live, that performance. It was amazing.
A great spirit of ceaseless turbulence on stage.
Berezhnikov did it to a great noise. I mean, he was celebrated for having taken this leap into modern dance and working with Martha Graham. Well, Mia did it as a matter of course.
She wanted to throw everything she had out. And I said, Mia, you cannot do this. This is history.
I promised my mother that I would tell her story. I had resisted for years. Her needs were so immense. If I wasn't vigilant, they would have consumed me. But in the end, I made this promise. It has taken me back along the river she loved to her beginnings. A stoic town at the edge of the Sava, where Croatia meets Bosnia. And a magical theater resting at Croatia's heart. Here, she became a star at 5. A cultural icon at 17, and an exile at 21. I wondered about the journey that led a young dancer growing up at the edge of the Western world to become one of the great ballerinas of her time. And I wondered if anyone remembered.
She was a child prodigy. She was a star. She was only 20. As she was banned from the stage.
Mia always said she never would have been a dancer if her mother hadn't beaten her into it.
Mia was a rebel. She was a rebel. Her father was mortified.
Peasant women had brought sick children to her to touch, presuming that her touch would heal.
He was Captain Von Trapp.
Hitler chased my father all over Europe.
I was at the house, you know, when the FBI came.
The attitude of the Communist Party, when once you go, you never come back, you're never welcome back.
But the Russian management, you know, they like us all to be in turmoil.
She had a big enemy there, a jealous lady, and so she vowed that Slavenska would never have any success.
She moved with such a magnetism, and I thought, well, why am I not seeing her in Swan Lake?
She could sense what was going on. Come to class, put the toe shoes on, and then what? Nothing.
When she made that return engagement.
She came back really as a ballerina.
You had the four great ballerinas. Slavenska got the standing ovation.
Mia had arrived.
My mother always said she'd been forgotten.
No. We never forgot her. We never forgot her.